Senate respectfully reports that they recommend that the House of Representatives and the Senate recess and convene in the House chamber at 3 p.m. on January 18th, 2024, and that a joint memorial resolution be introduced in their memory by their colleagues in the House of Representatives and Senate. A short program will follow the introduction of the memorial resolution. At the conclusion of the memorial service, the joint session will be dissolved. The memorial resolution shall be printed in the House and Senate journals. Respectfully submitted, Mike Stevens, Chair, John Hansen, Brandy Schaefbauer, Hugh Bartles, Orrin Lesmeister, House Committee. Respectfully submitted, Lee Schoenbeck, Chair, Jim Bolin, Casey Crabtree, Gene Hunhoff, David Johnson, Red Don Foster, Senate Committee.
Speaker Bartles has appointed himself to replace Representative Snyder on the Joint Select Committee appointed to arrange the memorial recognition for deceased former members of the House and Senate. Representative Snyder will not be here next Thursday. Reports of standing committees.
Mr. Speaker, the Committee on House Agriculture and Natural Resources respectfully reports that House Bill 1030, 1031, and 1033 do pass, and having been certified as uncontested, be placed on the consent calendar. Respectfully submitted, Roger Chase, Chair. Also, the Committee on House Taxation respectfully reports that House Bill 1001, 1018 and 1019 do pass. Respectfully submitted, Kirk Chafee, Chair. The Committee on House Health and Human Services respectfully reports that House Bill 1015 do pass. House Bill 1027 be amended and do pass, and having been certified as uncontested, be placed on the consent calendar. Respectfully submitted, Kevin D. Jensen, Chair. The Committee on House Local Government respectfully reports that House Bill 1026 be amended and do pass, and having been certified as uncontested, be placed on the consent calendar. Respectfully submitted, Becky Drury, Chair. The Committee on House Transportation respectfully reports that House Bill 1050 do pass, House Bill 1051 do pass, and having been certified as uncontested, be placed on the consent calendar. Respectfully submitted, Rocky Blair, Chair.
Motions and resolutions.
Representative Mortensen moved that when we adjourn today, we adjourn to convene at 1 p.m. on Friday, January 12th, on the fourth legislative day.
Second. We have a motion from Representative Mortensen to adjourn today and reconvene at 1 o'clock on Friday, January 12th. Any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. Motion carries. First reading of House bills.
House Bill 1073, keep interest earned on incarceration construction fund monies in the same fund. House Bill 1074, expand eligibility to practice as a dental hygienist under collaborative supervision of a dentist. House Bill 1075, modify provisions pertaining to the deadlines for the filing of certain election-related documents. Speaker Bartles requested a fiscal note on House Bill 1001, 1042, 1044, and 1073.
To House Health and Human Services, I'm assigning House Bill 1074, to House State Affairs, House Bill 1073, and 1075 will be assigned tomorrow. Missed the cutoff. Announcements? Are there any announcements? Representative Wise-Graham.
House Commerce and Energy tomorrow at 10 a.m. We have three bills and an informational briefing on the Southwest Power Pool, really called the power grid. Thank you.
Thank you. Representative Hansen.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. House Judiciary will meet tomorrow morning at 10 a.m., room 413. We have six bills on the agenda. Thank you.
Mr. Speaker.
Representative Derby.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I have two announcements. One is the Joint Committee on Appropriations has adjourned for the day, so no reason to go back. And we will meet again tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock for the State Investment Council, 8:45 for the South Dakota Retirement System, 9:30 Legislative Audit, and 10:15 Legislative Research Council. Mr. Speaker, I have another announcement.
Please do.
At 3:15 in room 414, we have Colonel Oakley and his wife Kelly will be doing a presentation. He is the 28th Bomb Wing Commander for Ellsworth Air Force Base. And I just wanted to let the interns, pages, and staff know that they're welcome to join us in this meeting. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Representative Derby. Representative Deutsch.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Tomorrow morning, 7:45, House Education meets, room 413, and we have three bills.
Representative Mortensen.
Thank you. House State Affairs tomorrow, 7:45 a.m. We've got seven bills and one resolution up.
Just be at ease for a moment, please. There's no objections. We're going to revert to item number 8 on the agenda, motion and resolutions. Representative Mullally.
Thank you, Speaker. I move to withdraw House Concurrent Resolution 6002 from House State Affairs Committee pursuant to...
That's good. That's all right. It's already been assigned to a committee, so we had to withdraw it on the floor. We have a motion and a second to withdraw House Concurrent Resolution 6002. Any further comments? Representative Mullally.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It was unfortunate that this bill was introduced. It was not ready for prime time at this time. So I asked to have it deferred or to reschedule it, but with our schedule as tight as it is, it was unable to be done. So I needed to withdraw that until I could be prepared to present this resolution. Thank you.
Any further discussion? This is a voice vote to do this. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed say nay. Motion carries. We'll revert to the end of the agenda. Any further announcements? Seeing that, Representative Drury, do you have something for the good of the House?
Every day. Mr. Speaker, I move this esteemed body be adjourned.
We have a motion and a second to adjourn. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed say nay. Motion carries. Thank you.